All right, we are here to see how this special tool works. This is way different and easier against traditional rotoscoping methods.
Slow down there, buckaroo.
There is something important to do before you start. You need to pre-cut your work area and take printer. If you don't do that, you will get crashes with highly possible. Because this tool uses real-time processing and don't need to work with large file sizes. So let's start real quick. Double-click your layer. We are gonna work in the front layer panel. Start selection with Roto brush tool first. Let me check the layer from composition to make sure if it's complicated or not. Because we will use refine edge tool for more detailed areas. Okay, we can still use Roto brush a little bit more. Then we are choosing refine edge tool from top panel or with alt plus W shortcut. You are gonna see something like white and black. This is sort of an alpha display for our effect. It allows us to make a smoother selection. If you think Roto brush didn't do a very good job to every edges, use refine edge tool. Everything looks okay for the first frame. We are moving to next frame. No need to work frame by frame. Skip several frames, wait after effects for the gaps to fill. Don't skip more than 20 frames. That looks decent. Just need to settle a few areas. You can't expect to make a single frame and leave everything left to poor little After Effects. Delete unnecessary refine edge selection from here. Make sure all edges look good and capture every detail. There are overlay buttons here. It helps us see what we chose and what we don't. Check at intervals to see how we're doing. As you can see, if you move to places that should not be selected with Refine Edge tool, corruptions occur and the program detects as if there are areas to select. Fix it real quick. So this is logic in general. Progress, jump to another frame. Progress till the end. Thank you. last frame. Check out the other frames that After Effects filled in to see what we're doing. Everything is okay, click to freeze button and apply the effect into our layer. If you spaced out and realize there are errors, don't worry. You can go back to front panel and click on freeze for fixing. We can turn back to composition now. Everything looks good. By the way, this is rotoscoping it. Don't expect perfect results for every footage. It's a pretty complicated shot that I use, and I got what I wanted. At the end, this is not a green box used clip and we are not making keen. This is second shot that I worked. I hope you enjoyed and see you next time.